What's up, guys? It's Ryan again from Lake Hickory Scuba and Marine. If you are new to our channel, do me a huge favor. Click this little subscribe button right here and ding that little bell as well. But you guys are going to be notified every time we upload new content. Now, we are down here for our family vacation. We're down here in beautiful Cozumel, Mexico, and we're staying at Hotel Cozumel. As you can see, we've got Dive Paradise here behind us. And this little lagoon area is a great little area for all different types of training, where you're doing open water training, you're doing rescue training. There's even a current here, obviously, and you could do drift training here. But it's a great little lagoon area for you to practice before you actually go diving. And what do I mean by that? Well, anytime that you're diving in a new area that you've never been, say in salt water, you might be a freshwater diver. This is your first time going in salt water. This lagoon's gonna be great for you to jump in and do a little bit of weight test. And that's what we're gonna do with one of our other instructors real quick. This is his first time here. So we're gonna jump in, do a little weight test with him, and then we're gonna go out for a little fun dive. And we're gonna be shooting several videos this week down here. And I've got some for my daughter's channel as well. But we're gonna just jump in, see what's here real quick, do a weight test. And that way throughout the week, we can make sure that we're spot on with our weights. All right, guys, so we are going to jump right in on this dive, and we're going to talk about a shakedown dive. What is a shakedown dive? Should you be doing them? Are they beneficial to you? And why do we as dive professionals actually do them? First of all, a shakedown dive can be anything from getting familiar with a new piece of gear to getting familiar with a new piece of or a new environment. It could be getting familiar with weighting concerns, or even if you're diving with a new person for the very first time, a shakedown dive is going to get you familiar with that person. I use this all the time as an instructor trainer to get comfortable with new divers, especially when they come in to take a professional level course. Usually their very first day of their dive master program, the first thing I say is, hey, throw your gear on, let's go jump in the lake and see what you're made of. And it's just a shakedown dive. It's getting familiar with a new area or new gear or whatever your requirements may be. It's a way to do it in a controlled manner versus just throwing yourself out there in the open ocean off a boat. That's not something you want to do. You always want to make a shakedown dive first. And we're going to see too that this does a lot of different things for us throughout this dive. But more importantly, it makes us more comfortable before we get out there in an uncontrolled environment. And this little lagoon here at Hotel Cozumel is absolutely perfect for that. This first little part is considered confined water, and we can actually use this for training purposes. So I could teach anything from open water to rescue to search and recovery to navigation. You name it, I could teach it in this little lagoon area, and it's a great little place to do a shakedown dive as well. Now, once we have our weighting spot on, I do want to talk a few minutes real quick about weighting requirements. The two divers that you're going to see in this video, of course, is myself and instructor OMB. Neither one of us are new divers. We are both very experienced. OMB has well over 1,000 dives under his belt, and I'm pushing 7,600 dives. That's 7,600 dives in my career. We are not new divers. We have experience in all different types of environments, both freshwater and saltwater, both shallow water and deep water, both overhead and non-overhead environments. We have a ton of experience. However, I do want to talk about how salinity levels can change your weighting needs. Even though we have tons of experience in salt water, if your salinity level changes depending on what type of salt water you're diving in, then your weighting requirements are going to change as well. And neither one of us really wanted to get out there on a boat and our very first dive out here in the ocean or out here in Mexico be difficult for us. So we did a weight test as soon as we jumped in. Now, our weighting requirements were spot on. I think I only needed 8 pounds is what I did the math on before I ever got in the water, and it was spot on. I'm only wearing 8 pounds right now. I believe instructor OMB is just barely wearing over about 10 pounds right now. I think he's got about 11 pounds on, and he's spot on with his buoyancy. So the shakedown dive was really, really helpful for us in getting our weights exactly where they needed to be before we jumped out on a boat several miles offshore and have to struggle with it. Another cool thing it did, it got us familiar with the local environment and what marine life was there, what ecologies were there, and what the surge and the current was going to be like. Every dive that we made during our trip here in Mexico was definitely a strong current. We made wreck dives, we made reef dives, we made wall dives, and it was a very, very strong current. Now, we're used to it in our local rivers and lakes where
we get in a little bottleneck sections, but it was definitely a strong current for us. And several dives, like on this particular one, we had to swim up into the current. I know on the wreck dive, we had to do the same thing. We had to swim up into the current, and then we allowed that current to push us away. But like I said, it gave us a chance to get familiar with the environment before we went out in the major open ocean area. And it gave us a chance to add dive time. What do I mean by that? Well, during our trip, we had multiple boat dives planned, but that was for days 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This first day, it was literally just getting checked into the hotel and relaxing. We wanted to add dive time. We wanted to go diving. We were down there in this beautiful tropical environment, and we wanted to go jump in, and that's exactly what this shakedown dive allowed us to do. I think we logged a total of 30 minutes during this first dive, and it was absolutely an amazing 30 minutes worth of dive time. I got to see all different types of underwater sea life. Here you can see we got two little puffer fish that we're playing with. And I call them little. These really wasn't little. These were absolutely giants when it comes to puffer fish. I have seen a few that's a little bit bigger than this. But, you know, especially in our lake, we don't get to see this every single day. But we got a cool little pyramid that we're going to swim up onto as well and kind of get to see it. I believe it was just either made of metal or fiberglass. It wasn't an old mine pyramid or anything. But it was something neat to see while we were underwater. So like I said, shakedown dives are very, very important, whether you are using them for weighting purposes, trying to get your weight spot on, maybe you're diving with a new piece of gear and you need to get familiar with it, or maybe you are trying to get comfortable in the environment. Maybe you're not used to salt water, you're only used to diving fresh water, or maybe you just want to add dive time. That's what a shakedown dive is all about. Even like I said, I use shakedown dives specifically for training purposes. If I'm training a new diver in a specialty area that I've never met before, or if I'm training someone who has taken a professional level course, whether it's their dive master program, their assistant instructor program, or their full on instructor program, then I will use a shakedown dive to kind of evaluate that diver and see where they're at and see what I need to do to work with them to get them where they need to be. But guys, get out there, make some shakedown dives. If you're diving with InstaBuddies all the time, I know sometimes it can be difficult when you get on a boat and now all of a sudden you get slammed with a buddy. But, you know, shakedown dives can be very, very beneficial to you. They can make you a much better diver, and to be honest, they can make you look even more professional. But guys, that's a shakedown dive. That's what it's for, is to use to get your weighting underway. It's used to get familiar with your environment. It's used to make you more comfortable. It's used to add additional dive time to your trips. And like I said, it's also used for training purposes as well. But guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's kind of short, but if you got any questions on shakedown dives, or you want to tell me your experience about a shakedown dive you've had, let me know down in the comment section below. Let me know about your experience, or if you got questions, I'll try to answer them the best I can. But guys, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a huge thumbs up and definitely share this video as well. But guys, as always, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Like us on Facebook, pin us on Pinterest, subscribe to us here on YouTube. And as always, guys, we appreciate your business.